If you are watching this video right now, chances are you are looking to properly size a marine air conditioner for your cabin space. Hi, my name is Sam and I am an HVAC professional here to guide you through the steps of calculating the proper sized air conditioner for your boat. Calculating the correct BTU for your cabin space can be a complicated process, but today, we are going to go over some parameters of BTU calculation that will help you reach a decision about your air conditioning needs. Before we get into that, first, we must understand what BTU is. BTU is a unit of heat that is commonly used in the HVAC industry to determine the air conditioner size meant for a certain space. It is defined as the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 pound of water by 1 degree Fahrenheit. Most customers believe that BTU can be easily calculated by square footage alone. This is not true and will lead to inaccurate results that could potentially harm their cabin space and air conditioner. In this video, we will go over some additional variables that need to be considered in order to properly make the most informed decision. The first thing to know is that BTU is calculated by heat load. What is heat load? The heat load is the amount of heat energy that is needed to be added to a certain space to maintain the desired temperature in an acceptable range. BTU counteracts a specific heat load. For example, an area with a heat load of 1,000 watts per hour would require 3,400 BTU per hour to counteract the heat. However, reality is not so simple. Factor number 1, heat emitting devices. Unlike most single rooms in a house, boats come compact with various equipment in a small cabin space that emit different heat loads in different intervals. Ovens, fridges, televisions, battery chargers, hair dryers. All of these things are variables that must be considered. If you have a lot of heat-emitting devices in your cabin space, it is ideal to increase the BTU to counteract the heat load. Factor number 2, people. Another important variable is people. Generally, the heat load of a sitting human is counteracted by about 400 BTU. However, in reality, people are not sitting all the time. The level of movement greatly affects BTU calculation. The number of passengers is also important. Each person in the boat contributes to the heat load. Factor number 3, user habits. Temperature preference is very important. The Air Conditioning and Refrigeration Institute AHRI assumes the human comfort zone is at 80 degrees Fahrenheit and 50% humidity. Most online BTU calculations are following this standard. The fact is, we know that a lot of people are not comfortable at 80 degrees. Some customers prefer the temperature to be below the 70s. Some people even prefer the low 60s. Your temperature preference can potentially double the necessary BTU. I want to note that this does not mean that everyone who is comfortable at a low temperature should oversize their unit. But we'll get into that later. Factor number 4, outside heat. Another variable is outside heat. Direct sunlight coming in through windows, doors, or hot air seeping in through the walls will greatly influence your heat load. Window size matters. Door size matters. Insulation matters. The frequency in which the door is opened and shut matters. The climate of the area your boat is situated in matters. Is it starting to sound a little complicated? If it were simple to calculate BTU, we would have published a table, but we don't want to mislead anyone. Some companies publish tables calculating BTU per cubic foot. Although it is not foolproof as we learned in this video, it generally works. The problem is that this BTU calculation is calculated to combat the maximum heat. This means in the hottest of summer days, under direct sunlight. It is easy to oversize the BTU this way. Oversizing. Why is that a problem? Let's say someone went online and calculated that they require a 16,000 BTU for their cabin based off of square foot alone. So, what happens during the colder seasons or during nighttime when after the sun has set? Since a lot of the factors that were used in the formula to calculate that 16,000 BTU are no longer present, the actual BTU requirement is now much less. If there is no sun, or if one is operating during a colder season, they will be facing a much smaller heat load. Let's return to the scenario where the customer purchased an oversized 16,000 BTU air conditioner. Now that the sun has set, imagine that the actual BTU requirement has reduced to 5,000 BTU. Since the 16,000 BTU unit has such a large capacity, it will cool the cabin extremely fast. The problem with this is that the unit will continuously cycle on and off since it cools the cabin too quickly. This will cause a surplus of humidity. Air conditioners usually combat this by removing humidity from the air the longer they run. If the compressor does not stay on long enough, it will not be removing the humidity from your cabin. An overly humid space could lead to problems like condensation buildup on walls and even mold and mildew. This is why we never recommend oversizing. So what is the answer? Since there is no such thing as a fixed heat load, as things are changing all the time, there is no set BTU calculation that will work perfectly under all conditions for everyone. A lot of people will call and tell us that they have a certain sized cabin. Then, they will ask us to tell them what BTU will work for that space. As you've now learned, there is no answer, and that is not how BTU is calculated. Finding a happy medium is the best solution. For example, if your space needs 20,000 BTU during the day and 10,000 BTU during the night and you install a 20,000 BTU air conditioner, it will work 100% of the time during the day and 50% of the time during the night. This can cause quick cycling during the night and may not be energy efficient. The answer is to find a happy medium. For example, opting for a 16,000 BTU. We want our customers to take all of the necessary factors into consideration and make their own decisions based off of their comfort. Calculations. The general industry rule for sizing an air conditioner is 14 BTU per cubic foot. For a cabin with a lot of direct sunlight, such as a pilot house, the recommended formula is between 16 to 19 BTU per cubic foot. For a cabin below deck with no windows and low heat load, the recommended formula is between 10 to 12 BTU per cubic foot. You can use these formulas to determine BTU for your cabin space. Just note that these numbers are usually a generalization and may not be sufficient during the hottest of days. Alternatively, they can also cause oversizing during the coldest of days. Our recommendation. We used to give BTU recommendations to our customers in the past through email or phone calls, but the feedback has varied since we cannot determine heat load remotely. The comfort of all of our customers is important to us. Our recommendation is to consult the boat manufacturer first. The boat manufacturer has the most experience with customer feedback about specific BTU sizes in your specific setup. If you are replacing a unit, we always recommend to replace with the same BTU unless the customer was extremely unhappy with it. If the previous air conditioner was oversized, the customer can try one size smaller. If the previous air conditioner was undersized, there can be a few factors at hand. The lack of air conditioning could be caused by several issues such as gas leaks, air leaks, outdated equipment, etc. Generally, we trust what the boat manufacturer originally put in. But it is completely up to your discretion. If you are not comfortable with calculating the BTU yourself, a local residential or marine HVAC technician can also inspect your boat and interview the owner for habits to give a proper BTU estimate. This way, the customers can continue using their air conditioning no matter the season with the greatest level of comfort. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video until the end. We hope that we were able to clarify some common misconceptions about BTU sizing. Please like this video if you learned something new. And if you want to be notified for more helpful videos in the future, please subscribe to our channel.